In this lesson, we will discuss two simple methods for solving one nonlinear algebraic equation, the graphing method and the incremental search method. The first method of finding a root to a nonlinear equation involves graphing the function and estimating the location of the root visually. The advantage of this method is that it is easy to implement by drawing on graphing paper, using a graphing calculator, or using software like MATLAB or Excel. One disadvantage is that if you graph the function by hand, you'll have limited accuracy unless you spend a lot of time narrowing the range of possible values. If you use a graphing calculator or computer software to graph the function, it will take less time than drawing the function by hand, but if you require a very accurate solution, it can still take much more time than more sophisticated methods. Another relatively simple method that can be implemented easily is the incremental search method. This method is sometimes called the brute force method due to its lack of sophistication. We will use this method to estimate the solution to the equation x cubed minus 0.3 equals 0. This equation is selected because we can compare our estimate to the analytical solution, which is approximately 0.669433. We start at some value of x, such as x equals 0, and march forward using a constant step size. Let's arbitrarily choose 0.2 as the step size. Now we calculate the value of the function at various values of x. Starting at x equals 0, we find that f of x is negative 0.3. Since we are starting at a negative value of the function, we will march forward with a step size of 0.2 until the value of the function becomes positive or 0. The next value of x is 0.2, and the function is approximately negative 0.292. Since the sine of the function is still negative, we have not yet reached the root. At x equals 0.4, the function is approximately negative 0.236, and we continue marching forward. At x equals 0.6, the function is approximately negative 0.084. At x equals 0.8, the function is approximately positive 0.212. Since the function has changed sign, we know the root lies between x equals 0.6 and x equals 0.8. We have a few options on how to estimate the root. We could simply use linear interpolation to estimate the root, and using this method, we would obtain a root estimate of 0.657, which is within 2% of the actual value. Using a higher polynomial fit, such as a quadratic fit, would give a better estimate. Additionally, you could repeat the incremental search method starting at 0.6 and using a smaller step size. The advantages of the incremental search method are that it is relatively easy to understand and write a program to implement. Additionally, if our initial guess at the root x0 is less than or equal to the actual root, we are guaranteed to find an estimate of the root. A disadvantage of the incremental search method is that it requires us to know that the initial guess is less than or equal to the root. This can be known by graphing the function first or having some information about the root, such as the root must always be positive. Another disadvantage of this method is that it is relatively time-consuming to calculate a very accurate estimate of the root, since that would require a very small step. Methods discussed in subsequent lessons will find the root much faster.